愿主与你们同在，
与你的心灵同在。
恭读圣马尔谷福音。
主愿光荣归于你。
那时候，宗徒们聚集到耶稣跟前，将他们所教的一切都向他报告。耶稣对他们说，你们来，我们私下到偏僻的地方去休息一下，因为来往的人太多，使他们连吃饭的时间也没有。他们便乘船悄悄地往偏僻的地方去了。人们看见他们离开，有许多人知道他们要去的地方，便从各城镇步行一起往那里去，比他们先赶到了。耶稣一下船，看见一大群人，就对他们动了怜悯的心，因为他们好像没有牧人的羊群，就开口教训他们许多事。基督的福音。
基督，我们赞美你。
各位在主内的弟兄姐妹们，大家早上好。在上个星期的福音当中，我们听见耶稣派遣了宗徒们出去传教，他派遣他们两个两个出去，他们被派遣去宣讲悔改的道理，驱逐魔鬼，以及为病人复油和治愈他们。那从今天的福音中，我们可以看到故事的延续。宗徒们从传教工作回来，并且非常疲倦，他们甚至在传教的时候都没有时间吃东西，所以他们又饿又累。耶稣了解他们的情况，所以对他们说，你们来私下到偏僻的地方去休息。耶稣也是同样的又累又饿，因为他也是一直在宣讲，所以他也要去休息和吃东西，以及向他在天之父祈祷。在继续讨论今天的福音之前，我想问你们每一个人，你是否知道天主要你在你的生命中做什么？这是我们在反思今日福音的时候所需要思考的问题。也许在进一步解释福音之前，我们更应该先思考这个问题。此外，我有没有意识到我是天主的传教士？的确，我们每个人都是天主的传教士，我们都被拣选并派遣去完成天主的工作。天主在这一生中托付给我们的使命是什么呢？我该如何履行这个使命？现在让我们继续反思福音。我们能从耶稣和宗徒们所处的情况中学到什么？首先，重要的是要全力以赴地完成天主托付给我们的工作。我们必须准备好，因为可能忙到连吃饭的时间都没有。如果我们发现自己因为忙于做天主的工作而不感到疲惫和饥饿，那么也许我们还不够努力。但这并不意味着我们不应该尝试找时间休息，也不应该忽视独自与天主祈祷的时间。 休息和祈祷让我们重新充满能量，继续完成天主的工作。勤奋是好的，但找到时间休息和祈祷也同样重要，尤其是在星期天，我们应尽量找时间敬拜天主，以及我们需要休息，并与家人和教区信友一起享受一些闲暇时光。但如果我们在星期天必须工作，那么希望我们能在一周的其他日子找到时间休息、祈祷，并与家人和朋友在一起。回到福音里的故事，不幸的是，故事并没有以耶稣和宗徒们休息而结束。人们跟随他们到他们想要休息的地方。可怜的耶稣和可怜的宗徒们，他们不得不推迟休息。耶稣看见众人如同没有牧人的羊群，于是对他们动了怜悯的心，开始教导他们。耶稣真的是一位好牧人，看看他是多么有同情心，他对人的关心和爱是如此之深，他会尽其所能地照顾他们。让我们今天记住，耶稣对我们每一个人的爱都是这样的，他感受我们的痛苦，他想要治愈我们，拯救我们。让我们继续寻求我们的好牧人耶稣，让他引导我们，帮助我们面对日常生活中的挑战和困难。当我们感到迷失时，耶稣他就是道路；当我们觉得无知时，他会指示我们真理；当我们觉得生活没有意义并想放弃时，他会给我们希望和新的生命。So good morning to you, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Just a few words in English for those of you who are not Mandarin speaking. So today, we are reflecting upon Jesus, our Good Shepherd. And we see in the Gospel how the apostles and Jesus, they are so very tired. They are very tired and also very hungry. Jesus had sent them out two by two on a mission, to preach the Gospel, to preach repentance, to cast out devils, and to heal the sick. So when they came back, they told Jesus all they had done, and he knew they were very tired. So they wanted to go to a lonely place and rest. But the crowds caught up with them, and they had no choice but to postpone their time of rest, and they had to still see to the people's needs. Sometimes we too might experience this in our lives, whereby we are already very tired, but still there is work to be done. We are already really exhausted, but still we need to serve others. And so we might have to postpone our time of rest. However, having said that, we must remember not to keep postponing indefinitely. We must rest. This is also something important. We must find time also to have some recreation. We need to find time also to pray, to be alone with God. Yeah, so this is also something important if we want to continue doing God's work. So yes, sometimes we have to postpone our rest. We have to go the extra mile, but it should not be postponed indefinitely. We must still find time to rest. And this is what it means also to keep holy the Sabbath day. So every Sunday we come to church, actually it's a time to rest from all our worldly things, and to rest together with our family here, and to pray to God. So the Sunday Mass is a precious time, a very important time. That's why we encourage everybody, at least once a week, no matter how busy you are, you should come to church. not out of a duty or obligation, but because this is your special time to rest and to be with God, so that you can have a blessed week ahead, recharged with the energy you get from God. Yeah, so this is very important for us to remember. Now, coming back to the Good Shepherd, each one of us also, we are a Good Shepherd. Let us not forget that. In our family, if you are the head of the family, then remember, you are the shepherd. And what does the shepherd do if not protect the family? Yeah, feed the sheep, provide for the family, and keep the family united together. Okay? So that's an important thing. All of us are shepherd. We are also sheep. God is our shepherd. And in turn, we are also shepherd. And we are taking care of those whom God has entrusted to us. So today, let us all remember that we are called to be good shepherds. And yes, the good shepherd needs to postpone the rest sometimes, but not always. You must also find time to rest so that you can continue your good service, yeah, and taking care of the family. Now, you know, it's important for our families also to pray together. Last time, the Redemptorist Fathers, they always go to all the churches and they remind the people, the family that prays together stays together. Yeah, and so in our families also, not just in church, at home, do we pray together? Maybe pray rosary is a bit difficult because even 20 minutes these days, we are so busy, even 20 minutes or so we don't have. But at least maybe before we eat, maybe on Sunday especially, we are together as a family at home. We spend just a few minutes before we start to eat just to give thanks to God, ask for God's blessing, and praying for each other, and pray to bless the food also, of course. Yeah? So sometimes we have to find new ways to pray together as a family. And that will help us to be more united and to be more peaceful also as a family. So today we thank God for the gift of all the shepherds, the priests, each one of us here also, we are all shepherds. As we continue to serve God's people, we pray that we will also know how to find a good time also to rest and also to have fun together and to be happy and relaxed so that we can serve each other, take care of each other better.